Now, I want to talk to you, two different people. So I want to talk to you as E.T. the Hip Hop Preacher, and I want to talk to you as the guy who was homeless. I want to talk to you as the guy who was a high school dropout. I want to talk to you as the guy who didn't meet his biological father until he was 30 years old. All right? And this declaration that I am is so important, because when I think about my journey, like, look, guys, this is what's so crazy. Like, even as I stand here, like, I can't believe I'm in Columbus, Ohio. Like, I can't believe I'm with Lewis Howes. Like, I can't believe I'm with the Summit of the Greatness. Like, guys, I was just homeless. Like, I was just literally sleeping in abandoned buildings. I was literally just thinking about committing suicide, right? And so what happened was, I was introduced, I was probably about 16, almost 17, and I was introduced to a pastor. A friend of mine took me to church with him. And it was the oddest thing. I went to church maybe about 3 or 4 times, and I didn't grow up in church, so I wasn't really there for like the religious aspect of it, but this was my best friend, and this is where he went regularly, right? And I loved it. It kind of reminds me of this Summit. You know, it was a lot of positive people, right? First time in my life being in an environment with just positivity, right? They would sing, and the pastor would speak, and we'd have a dinner after every church service. I think that's probably why I went, because it was like a meal, really. You know what I'm saying? When you're homeless and you're a high school dropout, you eating out of a trash can, like a hot meal is just unbelievable, right? That's why I'm a foodie to this day, right? And so, but I'll never forget, he would say to me, you know, maybe 3 or 4 weeks into going regularly, you know, he said to me, kid, what are you doing with your life? And I'm like, what does that mean exactly? He was like, well, what's your goals? What's your dreams? Like, I don't have any goals, any dreams. Like, my biological father wasn't in my life. My mom got pregnant with me at 17 years old. Like, I don't come from what we call, like, the Ola Mills experience. You know, I'm not like, you know, my great-grandfather, a picture with my grandfather, then my father and me. Like, I don't know what I want to do. And I remember maybe about the second month of coming to church, he would say to me, he'd say, you know what? You need to get your GED and you need to go to college. And I was like, what? Like, don't you know I'm living in abandoned buildings. Like, I'm working at McDonald's and I'm eating McDonald's. Like, my mother is 17 when she had me. She didn't finish barely finished high school. She didn't go to college. My grandma had 14 kids. None of them went to college. Like, we don't do college. You know, and it was just so weird. This is why you need to be in this type of environment, because this environment activates and give you permission to do. I'm sorry, I get excited because I'm not supposed to be on this stage. Listen to me, I was literally homeless. I was coming to church, not really taking showers. I wasn't brushing my teeth. And this guy looked at me and said, you need to get your GED. You need to leave Detroit. I'm going to send you to college because greatness is upon you. Guys, that's why this environment is so important, because what he did was he allowed me to see who I was before I could really see who I was. And he saw, guys, we just buried him about 4 weeks ago. And he saw something in me. Like everybody in the world now says, like, yo, E.T., I watch your video and this happened and that. And E.T., you know, I get inspired. I was 16, 17 years old. I had never spoken a day in my life, and this guy saw it. Like, he saw something in me that I didn't see, and he gave me permission to be where other people said I couldn't be. He gave me permission to believe I was great. He gave me permission to think I could change the world. He gave me permission to start something that had never started in my family before. He gave me permission to say, I am, I am, I am. He gave me permission to say, I am brilliant. Yeah, I might be different, but I am brilliant. Yep, I might be loud, but I am special. He gave me permission. And so the first thing I want you to do today is I want you to keep saying to yourself, I am, I am, I am, I am. And for those of you who hadn't quite started yet, I am. And for those of you who've gotten started, I am. Why? Because I can't believe that I started with a GED and that GED turned into a 4-year degree. Took me 12 years, guys. It took me 12 years. But Pastor would keep telling me, you are brilliant. You are special. Eric, yes, you're different. And yes, you're not doing it the traditional route. But greatness is upon you. You got to keep going. You got to keep going. You got to keep going. And the 12 4 years to get the 4-year degree turned into a master's degree. And the master's degree turned into a PhD. Guys, I can't believe it. I went from being a high school dropout, from being homeless, living in abandoned buildings, to eating out of trash cans, to Dr. Eric Thomas, to writing 6 books. Guys, are you hearing what I'm saying? Today, stop playing small and start playing big, because I am. All right, let's stop on three. 1, 2, 3. I am. 1, 2, 3. One, two, three, I am. And so he spoke this into me again, guys. Homeless, sleeping in abandoned buildings, eating out of trash cans. He saw greatness in me. And what I need you guys to do every single day, I want you to look in the mirror in the morning, in the afternoon, at night. Get your affirmations and your declarations, and I want you to speak to yourself, and I want you to speak life to yourself. And look, I need you to get all those people in your life that are speaking negative. I need them out. I need them out. And I need them out right now. I'm gonna say it again. I need them out. All those people that are not pouring into you, all those people who are not telling you how great you are, I need those people out. Why? Because you need to surround yourself with people who are great. And so I started going to the church, guys. Unbelievable. The pastor said, look, I'm gonna help you get your GED. I'm gonna send you off to college, right? And I can't believe it, but in that church experience, I met a young lady that became my girlfriend. Right, we're talking about the school of greatness, the summit of greatness, and something happens no matter who you are, if you're average or if you're good. When you get around greatness and you stay around greatness, you start listening to great podcasts and reading great books, and you start hanging around great people, and you start becoming a part of great masterminds. Guys, you just evolve. And I don't know what happened, but every year I went from a high school dropout and homeless to I started to becoming every single day more of who I am. And I can't believe it. My next goal is to win the Nobel Prize. Why? I had to come up with something. I just had to come up with something. I was like, I can't believe I wrote the book. I can't believe. When somebody said, Eric, you're not finished yet. You're not finished yet. So we're not finished in this room yet. So I'm in this space. And all of a sudden, this girl comes and becomes my girlfriend. I remember maybe 2.5, 3 years into our relationship, she called me. I'm sorry, I'm old. I call her on the payphone. I know some of you, you don't have the slightest idea what that is, right? But it's a place where you use quarters unlimitedly. It's just a lot of quarters, right? And so I remember talking to her on the phone, and she's like, look, my mom's not here. You know, I need you to get over here as soon as possible, right? I'm like, all right, good. I'm on my way. And so she comes out, and she sits on the porch, and she says, do you love me? I said, what? Are we like 18 years old? Like, yeah, but like, what? Like, she had this funny look on her face, and like, she was like concentrating. It was like serious, like, do you love me? And I was like, yes, like as much as an 18-year-old can love you. Like, what does that mean exactly? And she said to me, no, do you love me? And I said, yes, I love you. She said, okay. I opened up an envelope, and she showed me a letter where she was accepted into college. And she said, do you really love me? I said, yes, I really love you. She said, okay, if you really love me, I need you to go get your GED and follow me to college. And if you don't come, I'm breaking up with you. Oh, guys, listen to me. Look, I need y'all to do me a favor. I need you to get in the environment of greatness, because once you get in the environment of greatness, and don't play with it, like, don't play with greatness. Don't just listen to the podcast, right? Do what the podcast tell you to do. Like, don't just read the book, right? Do exactly what the book tell you to do. Like, I don't need you just to be in the mastermind, to be in the mastermind. Like, I need you to get in it and do everything you're told to do. And Didi said, if you love me, you'll get your GED and you'll follow me to college. And let me tell you guys something. When we talk about energy and inspiration and motivation, I can't explain it, but I never liked school. I never wanted to go to school, and I ran to night school, and I studied for 3 straight months, and I took the test, and the results came back. I passed. I left Detroit, and I never turned back. Listen to me, guys. You got to hear this. Number one, listen to me. Number one, I am giving you permission to be great. I'm giving you permission to be everything you were called to be, to do everything that you're capable of doing, to have everything you're supposed to have. I want you to have a house in California if you want one. I want you to have a house in Florida if you want one. I want you to have a house in Australia if you want one. Like, I was going to get my third house, and somebody told me, E.T., like, what are you doing? I said, I'm about to buy another house. Like, my wife has MS, and we need to get out of the winter, and we need to get some vitamin D. And they were like, I wouldn't do that if I were you. I was like, well, you're not me. Come on, guys. Listen to me. You have to be careful when you hang around average people. All they're going to do is tell you what they can't do. And that's okay that they can't do it, but that has absolutely nothing to do with us. We can go from being homeless and high school dropouts to having PhDs, writing books, and becoming the voice of a generation. We can do whatever we believe we can do, and we don't need anybody's permission to do it but ours. 1, 2, 3.
I am.
1, 2, 3.
I am.
1, 2, 3.
I am.
I am great. Listen to me, and I don't owe anybody an apology. I am phenomenal, and I don't owe anybody an apology. I am going to do great things, and I don't owe anybody an apology. I am. I was created to be great. I was created to do great things. I was created to have great things, and I will no longer ask others for their permission. Listen to me very closely. So in this journey, the first thing I had to do was to embrace my I am. I had to embrace that, no, I'm not a traditional student, but I'm a student nonetheless. That perhaps I can't do it the way everybody else does it. I'll never forget in the PhD program, a teacher told me, a professor said, you don't think critically enough, and you don't write well enough to do a dissertation. And I didn't get upset. I understood what she meant. She meant that you're not going to be able to do it the traditional route. What she meant was, you're not going to be able to use your academic prowess to make this happen. But what she didn't realize, number two, which is important, first, I embraced the I am. Number two, what she didn't realize is that I had average academic skill, but I had phenomenal will. I had average skill, but I had phenomenal will. And so in order for us to have and be and do everything we were born to do is, number one, we have to kill the noise. We have to stop going to other people and looking to other people for their permission to do what only we can do. Listen to me very closely. It's our dream. Nobody's going to see it like you do it. It's your dream. Nobody's going to feel it like you feel it. It's your dream. Nobody's going to be as dedicated to it as you are. It's your dream, and they don't have to understand, and they don't have to like it, and they don't have to do it. It doesn't make a difference. It's your dream, and you, my friend, have been given the task to make it happen, and you can't let anything stop you from doing what you were called to do. And so listen to me, I embrace the fact that I'm not an A student. I embrace the fact. But what she didn't realize is that I was going to go to Michigan State University's library, and in that library, they had dissertations. And I must have pulled down about 40 dissertations till I found the one that looked like something I could write. Don't listen to me very closely. Average skill, but phenomenal will. And I'm telling you today that there will be some roadblocks. I'm telling you today that there will be some haters. I'm telling you today that there will be some people in your family that don't understand. I'm telling you today, as you begin to take this journey, even as you're here, people are asking you, why would you come here? And why would you spend this kind of money? And why would you invest this type of time? And it's a scam. And why would you do this? And why would you do that? It's like, I just don't get it. Again, they don't have to. But what I need you to do is, I need you to kill the noise. I need you to embrace the I am. And however you get it done, I need you to get it done. What up, what up, what up, what up? It's your boy E.T. Look, y'all, do me a favor. Make sure you like and subscribe for more great content.
I work too doggone hard for you to tell me.